model of discretion, and I'm quick to take a hint. It's a very useful faculty, I find. From a fellow man's expression, I can tell in half a squint just exactly what is passing in his mind. Once I traveled on commission for some life insurance firms, and I called upon a friend of mine one day, and I gave a disquisition on the value of our terms, and I pressed him to insure without delay. I showed him how to benefit his heirs, if not himself. He merely took a heavy life preserver off the shelf. He didn't say he wouldn't, and he didn't say he would. He didn't have to say a single word. I understood. As a youth of 22, I'd a little love affair with a maiden who was all a girl should be. I'd no money, she had plenty, we'd have made a perfect pair, and I told her so one evening after tea. Yes, I asked her very nicely if she deigned to be my bride, and she heard me out with patience to the end. I can't recollect precisely what it was that she replied, but I know it had a non-committal trend. She didn't say exactly that she wouldn't be my wife. She spoke of my appearance, of my morals and past life. She didn't say she wouldn't, and she didn't say she would. But when she took the muzzle off the dog, I understood. I'm extremely fond of racing, of the free and easy sort, and there's nothing I don't know about a horse. You may often see me gracing little meetings where there's sport, where I do a bit of betting on the course. On the day that How's Your Father won the Monte Carlo Cup, I had backed the mare at 25-1. Was I pale and nervous, rather, till they put the all right up? Then I started for the bookie with a run. He didn't in so many words repudiate the bet, but he seemed to be suggesting that we'd never even met. He didn't say he wouldn't pay, he didn't say he would. But when he asked the clerk to hold his coat, I understood. I've a pal who's well provided with the necessary cash. He, in fact, is very opulent indeed. And last summer, I decided that I'd like to have a dash at relieving him of what he didn't need. I was absolutely stony, so I telephoned my friend, and I asked him, though I felt a trifle shy, if he'd lend me, say, a pony just to cover the weekend. Then I anxiously awaited his reply. He didn't quite refuse me or pretend he hadn't heard. He simply took his own receiver off without a word. He didn't say he wouldn't lend, he didn't say he would. But when Exchange kept shouting, "Lines engaged!" I understood.